Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, this is Best of Slot, and tonight we are back playing Dinosaurs Prehistoric Survivors because the game has just updated with a brand new update, the Nature Update, since last time we played it, and I figured we'd give it a go. We played Saurian just yesterday, and this is a fairly similar game in a lot of ways. It's pretty interesting. Now, graphically, the game's updated a lot. It now has a day-night cycle. It's now got weather. You know, we're going to get some heavy rain, stuff like that. There's now carcasses on the map and stuff like that. For those who missed the last video on this game, there is some pretty cool features in this. Plants and, well, animals in particular, carcasses, especially when they spawn in, now have a toxicity level. So each carcass is randomized by how toxic it is, so we don't know how toxic it is before we eat it. So, you know, you only really want to eat them if you're starving. There's things like, as your dinosaur, as your little Tyrannosaurus Rex, looking lovely and fluffy there. As it grows up and ages, the population of the world around you changes and stuff like that, so you get new dinosaurs and stuff to do. It's a pretty cool idea. The game is very much in development. I don't think it's really been receiving much hype, but I've got to say the graphic update is pretty great. I'm quite excited to see some good weather. This is not the best, but whatever. Here, there's some raptors over there. I'm not ready quite yet, so let's check on... Ah, there it is! Congratulations, you have come out of your comfort zone and are ready to venture the region. Blah, 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 blah. Okay. Chilesaurus, Utah Raptor, Triceratops, Tyrannosaurus are the four dinosaurs in here at the moment. And then you've got these plant lives. They've just been added as well for the first time. We also have skill points, as you can see. We can put points into these stats here. Let's go for health, I think. Yeah. So we've got health, stamina, attack damage, speed, toxic resistance, hunger stamina, thirst stamina, nutrition efficiency, and hydration efficiency. Some pretty cool things in there. Alright. Ooh! I'm gonna go square up to the Utah Raptor. It's bloody loud! Woohoohoo! Okay. Me, a little Utah Raptor. Da 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 da. Da da. Ooh! Can't hear me because of the thunder and the rain. I'm sneaking up. Am I gonna die? I feel like I'm gonna die. No, I'm victorious. Okay, we are ready to level up. Finally, I just murdered about 25 Chilesauruses, something like that. I don't know if this is gonna jump us to the next stage or if we have to get to level 3 to do that, so we'll find out. I just can't remember, basically. Save was menu. I, and then G. Absolutely nothing happened! Fantastic! But we do get to choose another skill point, so we only got health. Attack damage plus 10% sounds pretty good. Oh, I've already taken it. Oh, okay. I didn't really think... Oh, can I just click all of them? I'm just going to call all of them. There we go. Easy. Right, so I guess it has to be level 3. I really want us to get to a full-grown T-Rex this time. I don't think we did it last time. So I will once again wander off into the distance and murder 25 Chilesauruses until something good happens for me. Ah, it's going to be a long day. Okay, the idea from leveling up just from Chilesaurus is kind of depressed to me because I've killed about 4 so far and that's how much I've leveled up. So it would take about a billion years. So we're going to hunt some Utah Raptors. But there is 2 of them. Uh-oh, and I've been duped. Right, I just wanted to split them up, but that was my first goal, so we've done that. I'm going to do my roar, and hopefully I'm going to lead him around. Nope, 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 he's too clever for me. He's too clever for me. I just want to get an attack from behind. This'll work. I developed a new attack. Yeah, that's how it's done, son. Oh my god, look how much XP I got for that. I'm gonna have to kill like 8 Utah Raptors. Ugh. I wish your XP just increased ever so slightly as you played the game, you know? I just want to be lazy, quite frankly. You still have to walk around and hunt because otherwise you don't get any food and you die, but... Ugh. Onwards. Okay, folks, very nearly level 3. I've also found myself my very first carcass. It's over there on the right-hand side. Unfortunately, so is the T-Rex. However, the T-Rex is very kindly chasing down these two Chilesauruses, using up all their stamina and his stamina in the process. What I'm thinking
is that I should be able to sneak in here and take both of these kills, and the T-Rex is just gonna kind of... When the dinosaurs lose stamina, much more than my guy, they slow down so incredibly slowly that they may as well not exist anymore. So I should just be able to sweep in here and go... Bloop. Where have you gone? Bloop. And level up. Bam. There we go. Time to move on to the next growth stage, to the sub-adult. I was about to call it the adapt stage, and that's silly. Now, this is the one we got to last time. Very cool. I think you'll agree. Look at that. At times, the game is beautiful. I don't think they've got the nighttime quite bright yet. See that new roar? Well said, buddy. Well said. So, skill points. You can see we've now got a whole new tier. Attack damage plus 20%, which is pretty crazy. But it does mean your hunger stamina goes... Is that bad? What's hunger stamina? Oh, bloody... Oh. Yeah, so it means you need to eat more, basically. But that is still really good. Health plus 50 is a lot. I think speed is actually possibly one of the best ones you can get. And we're going to stop putting points into speed now. Okay. And let's check the population report and see what has changed on the island. The world has changed. The lack of carnivore presence has attracted many large herbivores to migrate to this region. This could be a great opportunity to obtain easy prey. However, with the ever-growing population of large herbivores, smaller herbivore populations start to decline due to their incapability of maintaining crucial territories. So, Chilesaurus is now moderate. Utahraptor is a bit more rare. Saurolophus is now very common, much more than the others. Triceratops is now moderate, Ankylosauruses have now appeared for the first time, and Tyrannosaurus Rex is still very rare. Resource trend as well, very cool, right? Steady increase in carcasses, because there's lots of herbivores, I guess, clearly. Well, this big population of large herbivores means the T-Rex has more things to hunt down, so there's more carcasses, whereas the edible plants have declined rapidly, and that's obviously because there's lots of big herbivores, so it's a lot easier for the... That's our civil office over there. We're going to go hunt it. It's a lot easier for the... Wait, what? There's a lot of big herbivores, so the plants die, basically, is what we're getting at here. All right, let's go kill our first dinosaurs, the big... Oh, there's a few of them. Did these fight back? I guess there's only one way to find out. I do really like the weather system, but I do need to say it's... it kind of shifts between them super quickly, so... It's basically like living in Britain. You know, you'll go outside in shorts, you'll be wearing shorts, you'll have a t-shirt on, it's nice and bright and sunny, you're gonna go play football if you're that kind of person who goes outside and has friends. I'm just kind of guessing here. Alright, calm down, lad. And then it'll turn into like an absolute monsoon 2 seconds later. Alright then! Let's go grab another. Now, I've been honing my tactics for how to do this. You want to walk up as close as you possibly can before you start to sprint, okay? Take it nice and slowly. Nice and slow. See, look at that! That is proper British weather. And I don't think this is set in Britain, modern day Britain. Look how close we can get without being detected. Look at this, it's insane. I'm going to be able to bite it before it even knows I'm there. Yeah, I actually did. I guess these are the best way to hunt for now. I guess we're going to murder a few Saurolophuses and then let's go kill one more and then we'll do some skipping forward. I really want to get to the next stage. I don't believe we ever got there last time. I could be wrong. I could definitely be wrong, but it's been a while. See, it's an area. It's actually burning its stamina right now. It's just running into the wall. Hello, love. Amazing. if I see any of the other new dinosaurs, we'll pop back in. I just wanted to show you what's going on here. So, whilst originally I would be hunting the Saurolophus, me and this one, we just kind of hit it off and we decided to get together, so that's why I'm inside it. And I'm wearing it as a hat! It's not even dead right now, it's actually alive at this point in time. You see, it's moving and breathing. It basically walks into the tree and got a little bit stuck. Well, we're having a great time. That's really what matters. I'm just going to eat it from the inside. No jokes. There we go. That looks a little bit... The game is still early access, I think. It needs a little bit of love. But hey, what doesn't, right? We all need a little bit of love, folks. Love makes the world go round. Even for dinosaur games. Can I not jump anymore? I can't seem to jump. Oh, look. It's British. Okay, we do have to pop back in. It's only been a couple of seconds, but I've just spotted our very first Triceratops off in the distance. Now, if I remember correctly, we actually managed to kill a Triceratops as the sub-adult just by sticking to the back. The Dark Souls tactic, you know, you stick to the ankles, and you nom 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 nom, you nip at the ankles until the thing glim and dies. Hello. I'd like to see you in the daytime, but I'm just gonna bite you on the booty, if you don't mind. Don't take it personally. Don't take it to mean any more than you think it already does. Oh, it's fighting back. It's fighting back. This may have been a mistake. Can't tell if I'm taking damage. Can't tell if he's taking damage. I don't know if anything's going on right now. I think I'm winning. It's hard to tell. Oh no, I'm actually dying. I'm actually totally dying. Oh, there we go. That was a little bit closer than I would have liked.
But we leveled up.
Level 4, and we can get... I think the health boost is really good. I do lose 5% of the speed I just got, though. Eat Restore and Drink Restore just aren't worth picking up. Stamina plus 15. How much do I have now? Oh, that is a lot of stamina. But I think I need to be able to survive when I get into combat like that. I think we might just go for... I'm going to go for the health. And then the attack damage. I think. I'm a big old toughy now. That's what matters. Okay. Is there any more dinosaurs I haven't seen yet? We haven't seen the Ankylosaurus. I don't think we've ever seen the Ankylosaurus. So we'll keep an eye out for one of those. Otherwise, you've pretty much seen everything else, and we shall move on. It's not the, not the smartest Triceratops in the world, is it? It just sat there as I bit it on the ass over and over again until it died. Nighttime has approached. There's a carcass, by the way. That's what they look like. They're just kind of lying around. You can eat them, but the toxicity is really high. These are like a desperate last measure if you are completely out of food, basically. There's a fully grown T-Rex in front of me, and this is where the episode either ends or continues, basically, because I'm going to give this a go. And if I die, there is no way I'm going through all this again, because it's taken bloody ages. But the T-Rex has no stamina, so I'm wondering if I can just get behind it when I start the attack. Maybe, just maybe, we can fight it like we used to fight the Utah Raptors at the start and not get bit. I'm clearly outmatched, right? But I have cheating on my side, as I always will. I think he's trying to hunt down that Sorilophus over there, so if we can just sneak up, go for a little bit of a sneaky attack here. I'm gonna go for it. I'm probably about to die, and the video will end, because there's no way I'm doing this again. The game has the same... Not only does this game not have a save system, it says save there, but... Okay, I've got a plan. Lure it around the tree. Can I walk? Okay. Hello. What do you think you're doing? Apparently what you're doing is nearly killing me and ruining my entire plan with the T-Rex. Okay, I need some more health now, unfortunately. Let's go grab some water. He's just going to keep following me, I'm pretty sure. I got a little bit of XP there as well. If we kill the... I can kill the Rex. We can obviously not fight it one-on-one like that with the Utah Raptor. Even that Utah Raptor nearly had me dead. So, let's grab some water, which will hopefully increase my health bar as well. Yep. The Rex is still coming for me. Look at him in the distance. Like a freaking Grim Reaper sneaking over the hill. But... the dinosaurs just never seem to get their stamina back. Okay, I'm on good health. Full thirst, I'm ready. I just need to get around his back. I'm a rogue, we do it from behind. Okay, I need a tree. Come over here, pal. It's so slow, maybe I can just... if I roar, get my increased stamina. It's not working. It's totally not working. I need to get out of here. This is a mistake. This is a terrible idea. All my health is gone. He was nowhere near me, but it doesn't matter. No, I'm gone. I'm outie. Never mind. It's going to offer you guys something nice and dramatic. But now I feel like I have to. What's more important? Me battling to the death with a giant T-Rex or showing the T-Rex? I mean, T-Rex stage shouldn't really make a difference, I think. This was my plan, right? Get behind the tree, like so. And then... you ready? Ready? Go! Go! Nope! Can't get hit! Yes! It's coming together! The plan is working! There we go! That's how it's done! You can always game the system, ladies and gentlemen. Doesn't matter what you're doing, you can cheat and break your way out of it. No problem whatsoever. I expected more stamina for that, I've got to say. More XP, I should say. There we go. It's the first time I've killed a big T-Rex, I think. Right, we're going to go get some water and I'll carry on going. Hopefully I can find an Ankylosaurus. I just got killed by a Triceratops. I was about 5% XP from leveling up and I got cocky. Where do I start? Is it at the start of level 4? I was so close! I'm an idiot and I'm absolute idiot. Oh, and it takes so long. Oh, kill me now. Okay. Back to work! Back to blimmin' work. I know this has been a stop-start low video. Sorry, chewing this. There we are. But I've got to say, the time of day thing is really impressive. Like, look at that. That is beautiful right there. My lovely little Rexy just... Look at that sunset. Hello? There's somebody nearby. Oh, hello. This should be the kill to get me to level 5, so you may as well hang around for a few seconds. Plus, I'm tired of restarting every 5 bloody seconds. So, come here. Nom nom nom. Nice. Up booty shot. I feel like I've said the word booty a lot of times in this video. More than usual. Oh no, there's a... Oh, okay. There's a large log. What will you... How? Are you kidding me? Stupid log betrayed me. Oh yeah, let my enemy walk through the log, but when I want to walk through the log, no, no, no. How tall is that grass? One. Should be it. One more. Bonk. There we go, G. Skill points, and I think we're going to take attack damage. I don't care that much about my hunger stamina. I want my attack damage as high as possible. So, the final level, folks, before we hit a big, bad daddy T-Rex. Mommy T-Rex? Mama T-Rex, I don't know, whatever you want to call it. Okay, folks, just found our very first Ankylosaurus. Now, if I had to hazard a guess, the Ankylosaurus is going to be a bit of a fighter, right? It's going to be like the trike, it's going to fight back when I try to bite it in the face. The thing I'm worried about is my tactic for all of these dinosaurs... Are you squaring up to me, son? Oh my god, you actually are. In pursuit. My tactic for these dinosaurs is to attack from behind, right? That's not going to work for an Ankylosaurus for obvious reasons. Apparently I was wrong and the Ankylosaurus actually attacks from the front like an absolute bloody maniac. Okay, the Ankylosaurus just tried to bite me to death. Okay, that's fine, that's probably science. I'm gonna try to get some health back. Which is a slow, arduous process, as you can see. But the Ankylosaurus is out of stamina, so it takes about a billion years for it to get anywhere, as you can see. There's a lot of science going on here today. I'm just gonna get to full health, and then we're gonna kill... I don't know why it's glowing blue from underneath. It's kind of got this whole neon sign thing going on, and it also appears to have a waddle, like a chicken. That's fine. Are you actually just walking up to me, aren't you, son? You're a cheeky little so-and-so. Alright, I'm gonna try to get behind it. This is how I kill the Triceratopses, so hopefully it works. There we go, look at that, beautiful. Now we can get a proper look at it, sort of. It's very, very blue. It is just lighter blue underneath. It's what's called counter shading, which is something I think I've talked about 50 times in my videos. What's that noise? Oh, it's Rexy. Oh, no, 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 no. I know in theory I can kill a Rex. We've done it before, but it just feels so risky, you know? And that Anki kind of kicked my ass a little bit. We'll talk about counter shading once more. It's how most animals are lighter underneath and darker on top, especially prey animals, blah, 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 because that means the shadows are underneath and it kind of counteracts the lighting of their body with the lighting from the sun. It's all very exciting. I'm going to go try to kill the Rex. I was thinking about it. I've decided. I'm not that far into level 6, the experience source level 6. So if I die, it's not the end of the world. Is it the end of the world? I already feel dirty thinking about dying. I was thinking about dying yesterday, right? Go with me on a little tangent here, okay? As I prattle on about my own life. I was heading down to London to sign some papers for my move. What's that? Oh, it's a Triceratops. Come on, Rexy. Come on. There we go. Good girl. Just gotta let her use up all her stamina, so I'm gonna ring around the rosies a little bit. Anyways, I was sitting on the train just looking out the window. It was raining and it's all depressing, and I mean, I love the rain, so it wasn't depressing, but it's depressing to normal people. And I was just thinking, how weird is it to be dead? I know that sounds weird, but just try to imagine, like, I was trying to imagine what it's like to not be able to imagine things, if you know what I mean, or to have no thought processes whatsoever. And I think it's just something impossible to wrap your head around. Oh, no. I may be in a spot above here. I'm going to go for attack. Okay, right, they're distracting each other. I'm going in. I didn't get the kill, although he's nearly dead, so. Eh. We got a free Ankylosaurus out of it. Could be worse. Eh, whatever. No more depressing topics. Still, we're getting there, folks. We're getting there. We're finally bloody getting there. I believe this Triceratops kill, when I get it, if I don't die in the process, should be the kill to kick me off to level 6 and hopefully that final... Let's call it an evolution, because that's basically what it is. So, the Trikes are actually really cool. Now, they hurt a lot if they get on top of you, but because they're kind of cocky, but not an Ankylosaurus. The Ankylosaurus, I was going to call it a Cockysaurus there. The Cockysaurus, it kind of struts up, like a bedbug reference. Kind of all, you can't see me, but, you know, push out your shoulders and arms out and, you know what I mean? You guys get me. That's what an Ankylosaurus is like. The Triceratops is more like, it just doesn't care. It's just wandering around doing its own thing. I can walk inside it, as you will see in a second. And it just, not a care in the world, does not give a lemon until you start to bite it. And then it maybe starts to care. Until then, you can do like a dinosaur centipede project. Oh, and even then it doesn't care. Oh, are we caring? Sometimes they learn to care. Sometimes less so. Apparently it is in pursuit. Oh no, oh it was enough. Right, ladies and gentlemen, it is time. Let me get a nice thumbnail just in case. Go look at that beautiful stuff. G. Oh, I'm quite excited. I really can't remember if I've ever seen this. I might have done. In which case, I didn't really need to overwrite my save file. There we go. Fully grown T-Rex with a pointy little head. Kind of cute, right? Very... Oh, God, excuse me. Very cool. So, the world has changed. Oh, it's the same. Oh, no, it hasn't. The world has changed. The abundant presence of weak but relatively large herbivores has intrigued large carnivores to migrate into this area in search of easy prey. With large carnivores now dominating the lands, herbivore populations start to decline as small carnivores shift their survival strategy from active hunters to scavengers to avoid direct competition with these powerful giants. So Chilesaurus and Utahraptors are now both very rare. Sorolophus is now moderate instead of very common. Triceratops and Ankylosaurus are rare, and T-Rex is absolutely bloody everywhere. So we'll just spend... got my skill point. Hello. Oh, look at these. Bleed chance. Attack damage plus 25%. That's crazy. I like so many of these. Health plus 75 is pretty insane as well. I think I'm going to grab that first. I really like the idea of a skill tree in a game like this. The game does have basically the same problem that Saurian has, if we're honest, in that there just isn't anything to do. I've enjoyed making this video and poking fun and... talking about death, but I still think that looks pretty cool. But I've got to be honest, completely honest, in case people were wondering about buying the game for themselves, in the downtime between my little recording bursts, like I've been doing today, I have been a little bit on the bored side. Really, just because there's nothing to do. At times it's very pretty. I don't think it looks great at nighttime, actually, and when the rain comes down. It gets this weird kind of glossy effect. It's actually the same effect that Jurassic World Evolution has in the rain, and people keep doing it for water effects, and it always looks bad, so I don't know why people keep doing it. But during times like this, it looks pretty great, if you don't look too closely. I think anything with a bloom effect looks great, though. I love me a bit of bloom. The original Xbox 360, when it first came out, and every game had massive amounts of bloom on it, that was my heyday, I tell you. Oh, we're just going to try to kill this Rex. There's no new dinosaurs to show. It's just Rexes absolutely bloody everywhere, as you can see. Which I don't think is very realistic, but whatever. You're not going to scroll to me, right? I don't think so. I think we're friends. I'm going to try to murder you, but we are friends. There we go. Easy peasy. I guess. Was I doing something different there? Ah, see, that's my right click attack. That uses stamina, whereas the left click attack doesn't. I was wondering why I ran out of stamina really quickly there, and that's what I was doing. That's about it, folks. I'm just trying to get a nice thumbnail. It's important, okay? I need the light in the right place, but stop bending your head. You're not Beckham. Let the bar recharge. And then... Just turn your head forward, you big old nerd. Thank you. Is that so difficult? What's wrong? What was your major malfunction? One more time to finish things off in style. Okay, we are going to end it there. Thank you very much for joining me, ladies and gentlemen. This is Dinosaurs Prehistoric Survivors. Yes, the name is terrible. Hopefully the game does keep developing. Hopefully, I don't know what if this is, if it's like an indie project on the side for the devs, or if it is actually selling more than I expect it has. I can't imagine it's done that well, but I don't know. You know, I could be entirely wrong. I hope it's done well, just because it's a dinosaur game. And there is a vast improvement over the last time we played it. Just the day-night cycle and everything, it mixes it up. It keeps it interesting. It does definitely have the problem that there's not much to do, but that's kind of a problem with all these games at the moment. And the weather does change a little bit too quickly. As you just saw, it's a little bit bam, you know, no clouds, bright sunny sky, and then Britain mode. You get me. But I like some of the ideas. The population changing and stuff like that is a very cool idea. Just hope they can develop it a little bit more. And it'll be really cool because at the moment they're working on adding the Triceratops to the game. That is definitely a point where we will come back and give that a go for ourselves and try it out. I hope you fall. Thank you for joining me, my lovely ladies and gentlemen. I'll see you lovely folks next time. Cheers, much love, as always. Bye-bye. A little shout out at the end. This video and others like it would not be possible at all without the support of you guys watching me at home, and also everyone on this Patreon page right here who supported me in the last month. If you want to help out as well, you can do so at patreon.com/bestinslot. Every little really helps. Cheers.